what sound Bonnie makes so that you can know when he's in a room. So we'll just continue night two. We'll try and beat that. See if we can beat night three today as well. That'd be nice. Well, in this video. So we'll be making more videos of this game today. Volume's a bit loud. I just realized. So there we go. That's better. Ugh. Anyway, remember the stuff from yesterday. New animatronic. It's Bonnie. I've got a list now for him. Follow the music. That sounds like an animatronic, I'm not sure. Okay. Sounds like it's in here. Was that Bonnie? Where do I go? I heard the sound of music in here. I heard music. I don't hear music anymore. There's no music. Okay, Bonnie's over there. I simply don't hear anything. I don't know. They told me to follow the music. I don't hear any music anymore. Music's just gone now. What is this? I don't hear any music anymore. What the hell? I simply don't hear anything. Sounds very close by now. Is it in here? No. Here, maybe? I don't know. It's the hallway again. I don't know where to go. Try this. It sounds close here. Wait, what happened? Did we do it? Finally? I hear music. Is he gonna be at the door again? I don't know. Do we beat the night? Can we get a confirmation game? That'd be nice. Please. I'm gonna assume we won because we didn't get a jump scare. This is a tough game though. It's definitely different compared to your typical fan game, which makes it interesting, but also very difficult. Or I'm just being trash, I don't know. Could be both. You will pull back again to safety as the sounds of the untuned music box wind down. The shadow offers another story as a reward for completing the task. Would you accept? Sure, why not? Performs a jump scare. Wait, that is the puppet though, isn't it? In the shadow. This story I tell to you is the true story that I pray you never forget. There was a boy who laid awake at night during a harsh downpour. Beneath the covers of his bed, he closed his eyes and tried to ignore the storm just outside his room. Enveloped in darkness, a sensation of creeping discomfort kept him from falling asleep. The roars of the storm were nothing compared to the restlessness that the shadows cast from the window gave him. He felt eyes watching him from afar. The boy opened his eyes and looked toward the window. But nothing was there. He tried to go back to sleep. Seems like it's him. He opened his eyes again, and out of the corner of his eyes, he spotted it. The hollow, white eyes of a living shadow. It appeared just as quickly as it went away. His uneasiness pushed to the side by growing curiosity, the boy got up from his bed and approached the window. From out of the glass, he could see it, the silhouette of an animal, darker than the night around it, and void of color even light struck its frame. Running off the trees with a similar object stuck in its mouth. His favorite toy, stolen again, being carried towards the forest, the boy couldn't help but follow along the shadow's path. Looks like a dog. The same dog. That looks like the shadow of the dog that the boy killed. The night air was freezing. Brazen winds carrying countless droplets that hit the skin like marbles, their impact deafening any other sound other than the imposing thunder. Wait, so is that shadow like, so it feel like in this world, if you die you become a shadow, so maybe like the shadow we are seeing is something that's dead, and maybe you only you see the shadow if you're the person that killed whatever it is. So maybe this shadow we're seeing, is it something that our character has killed? I don't know. We'll just have to see later on in the game. Anyway, yeah, said that already, okay. Call it premonition, but he knew where the shadow had gone to. That place at the edge of the forest where he had last left the family dog. He was sure he would find it. Yep, it led straight to the dog. Dog's grave, yeah. It's definitely the dog. Standing in front of the grave once more, the eyes from the shadow had gone away. In its stead, the twice stolen toy robot now lay on top of the muddy mound. But this time, it was moving, its tiny plastic arms flailing violently from side to side, its head rotating in place. The movements were sudden but clear. Unprompted by any outside influence, a spark of life was trapped inside this tiny vessel. Interesting. Fascinated by such discovery, he picked up the toy from the ground and held it tightly with both of his hands to prevent it from escaping his grasp. Smiling from ear to ear, the boy headed back home. Interesting, very interesting. 3 nights remaining.
Actually, there's not 3 nights, because it's a custom night.
Oh, what's night 3 going to be like then? Because I remember when I died to Bonnie, it said something about Chica. So I wonder if she's going to appear this night. And what our objective is. Let's see. Don't stand still. Enemies will move into your room if you take too long, hiding next to you. If a shadow is in the same room as you, it'll wait for you to move before attacking. Find it and scare it away. Oh, gosh. A new presence has appeared in the building. It moves slower, but it's harder to detect. Be patient when leaning. Oh, great. Enter the kitchen. Oh, I should have probably gone to the right side then, because that's where the kitchen is in the Five Nights at Freddy's 1 location. Fuck. So how do I know if a shadow's in here? Do I just have to do a 360 spin every time I enter a room? Just to be sure. Wait, I got a key. Oh, I gotta find a key. No. Shoot, I gotta find an object this time. So we gotta not just find the kitchen, but we gotta find the key to it. Okay. So to the right should be the kitchen. Yeah, kitchen. I remember location. I don't know if that was Chica or not, if we die, or just whatever the new presence is. Oh, that's something. I don't know what that was, though. How am I gonna find a key? No key in here by the looks of it. Nope. I'm gonna travel along the outside first. Is it on the right hallway, maybe? Well, what's that? Oh. God, the jump scares are terrifying in this. I hate that. I hate it so much. Chica is less patient than Bonnie. You can wait for her to arrive to you and scare her off to make sure she goes away temporarily. Huh? How? How do I scare her off? Huh? That's confusing. Yeah, I don't know. I'll just give this one more attempt. If we die, we die. This game's too confusing for me. I mean, if I have to, I'll look up a tutorial, though I don't want to. Stand still, yeah. And they get more aggressive too, so that's crazy. I need to find a key somehow. I don't know where to find the key either. That's another difficult part.